All right. Let's begin playing Star Wars. Oh shit. Wow. The game fucking thought I was AFK. I was just listening to music before I had to start streaming today. All right. Well, let's log into our character. Huh. Kaiju was here. Earlier before the thing started. Wow. Alright. I think, last time I played this, I stopped. I'm supposed to do something with, like, a gang or something. Just, here's, like, what are they, like, called? Red Suns or something? I don't know. Or Black Suns, maybe. Because Red Song is the... Or Red Sun's the name of a song from Metal Gear, so I don't think it's that. Alright, well, let's, drive on over there. A bunch of side quests as well.
Please select an available travel route.
It says we wanna... Wait, why do we wanna go here? Is crisis control? What's crisis control about? Let's turn in the guild ledger. I don't know, I'll worry about that later.
Have a safe and pleasant stay.
I wanna focus more on, completing this planet. I'm still in the prologue, technically, Kaiju. Cause, like, the prologue is, the planet you start out on, and then if you're Republic, going to Coruscant, and then, if you're on the Empire, going to Drummond Kos. And then after that, like, Chapter 1 starts, and, like, you get your ship and stuff, and that's, like, the start of Chapter 1 for all the classes on SWTOR. But, I remember you, we were talking about, like, MMOs. If you want an MMO that feels like a single-player game, or one that you can play like a single-player game, SWTOR is it. So, how do I get down here? I'm trying to find my way down. But, I only completed the first planet I started on. Because, I completed the Sith Warrior storyline. Yeah, technically the MMO is free. Paying for it is optional. The only reason if, to really pay for it is if you want, like, things that make the game more convenient, I guess. But it's really not optional. I also think if you're playing for free, you can really only play as a human, but I think humans are... I honestly play as a human most of the time. So... And I think with a free account, also, there's a certain amount of money you can possibly have. Like, you can't go over 1 million credits or something. But, I mean, if you're just playing it for the story... I think free, playing the game for free is completely doable. But, yeah, it's a pretty good game. I'm trying to remember when the game originally came out. I think it might have been during when it was, either Burning Crusade or Wrath of the Lich King for WoW. This game's been out for quite a bit, I think. these things. Retrieve stacks of money. Assuming these enemies will have the money. Alright. Oh wow, this is gonna take forever. I gotta like kill. And if only they don't all drop it, this is gonna take a while. Oh well. Okay. Let's head on over to the next set of victims. Man, I don't know if I want to do this quest anymore. It's like, they're not dropping the... Or no, I'm in the wrong area. I mean, this is just some dumb side quest, though. It doesn't really matter, I think, if I don't complete it. In fact, I'm going to, stop, wait. I thought I did that quest. Oh, well. I remember doing Hammer Station, like, off-screen. Oh, well. So just want to track that and Hot Pursuit. There we go. Alright, let's sneak on over here. I had a really good day yesterday, I think. Well, kinda good. I felt baked the entire day. And I don't do drugs, but, like, I remember one of my friends was telling me, like, yeah, you seem more autistic than you normally are. And, I feel like I might be, I guess, like, the way I feel must be, like, how, you are when you do, like, a lot of weed or something. Or, like, I don't know. Oh, wait, there's a thing here. Some garbage I can pick up. What's my blood sugar? It's 268. There's a grace period, so I'm gonna have to replace my sensor in 42 minutes at some point. Let's just take a bit of insulin real quick. Yeah. It's always fun getting, poked. Alright. Wait, destroy Black Sun Forces. Oh, that's it. This is a bonus objective. Okay.
This Hydra supply station better not rust my blasters. I'll be needing them for a good long while.
Does this person count towards killing Black Sun Forces? No. Well, why doesn't he count? He is clearly a Black Sun person. Bam. It's like we have a pistol, but we're like the scoundrel really plays like a fucking melee kind of rogue type character. Cause why shoot people with your gun when you can smack people with your gun? Use your gun as some kind of club. just like constantly pistol whip people. Let's grab this aluminum. Shut off. Okay, so we're shutting off these valves. Okay. I'm stuck on the thing. There we go. Pain, grab that for us. Oh, I missed one of the things to pick up. Okay. There we go. We're gonna have to backtrack and get that other valve turned off. Let's start heading on over there again. I was like playing Black Desert, cause I ended up like just going to bed and having like my character like just AFK fishing or whatever. And then when I woke up, I was like looking at what I caught, and apparently I caught a fish that was worth like 4 million coins or something. I'm like, oh Jesus. I wish I found a fish that was 4 million coin worth like $4 million. That'd be neat. It's a $4 million snack of some kind. Alright, there we go. Why are we going only over here?
Hey, what are you doing? Get away from that! Back off! This is our hydro supply, and we like it broken. Now get lost!
Who are you?
What are you kids doing here?
We live here. Who do you think you are, stomping in here like this? We need this water. We don't have any money, and there's nowhere else in the district to get water for free. We'll die if it gets shut off.
Where are your parents?
What happened to your parents?
They died in the war, all right? We're on our own now. Just leave us alone. This is the only place we've got, and the only way for us to get by.
Why are you still in my way? I don't wanna, like, I think even if I was playing, well, I don't know. I don't know what my Sith Warrior might murder them. But he's like a psychopath. I don't think, yeah, what if I helped you get by?
If I gave you some credits, would you be able to find a new place to go?
Yeah, that'd be a start. It'll take a lot, though. Are you gonna give us enough?
No way! No, here, take these supplies.
This should take care of you and your friends.
Whoa! I've never even seen that many credits before. We can trade for a long time with these. Thanks!
At least these aren't like kids that you want to murder because they just like randomly pickpocket you and you're wondering, where's all my money? Like in the, in Fallout 2 or something. Because, I feel like those kids, like, most people end up getting the child killer perk because they're mad that all their the stuff they got was stolen by little kids. Some more aluminum. Go grab that. one more thing we gotta do in this part of Coruscant. Climb up this ramp. I don't know. I think I'm just gonna not stealth walk all my way over there. Like, I'm just gonna get on my car. I think that's a better idea. So, zooming on through. And hopefully these, we don't have them shoot us and then they knock us off our car. There's the Black Sun headquarters. I wonder how we're gonna screw over Skavik, now, over here. Oh crap, I didn't see all these guys. There we go. Alright, so what do we gotta do here? Retrieve holo recording fragments. Oh, okay, this is probably like stuff that will incriminate Skavik. There we go. Just freaking snap their necks. Oh, that's one holo recording fragment. Looks like we gotta get like three more. Oh yeah, I ended up picking a second class archetype, and I was thinking about it, and I was like, I don't know why. I ended up, because I know I was gonna pick the mercenary and stuff. How big is your SWTOR game? I think the game's pretty decent sized. It goes up to level 80, I think, and my character's only level 25 at the moment. I think there's a lot of story to do. Like, it'll take you quite a while to do all the story for, all the classes and then the DLC. Then not only that, just because the way the game works, there's a lot of different outcomes that the story can, take. So, like, almost like, Your game might be, like, when you play, it might end up have a different ending than mine, I guess. And then, like, something you do in the, like, let's just say level 1 to 50, it might remember what, like, something you did, or, like, someone's life you might have spared by the time you're doing, like, maybe level 70 or level 80 stuff, right? Is it like, file size. I don't know. Oh yeah, because I remember, you have really bad internet, Caillou. It'd probably take you quite a while to download. I'll look it up for you, and then, let you know next time I talk to you on Discord. I can definitely look that up. Because, like, the other thing, too, you have to keep in mind is that the game will randomly get patched and stuff. Because it's an MMO, they'll be constantly adding content and stuff. Alright. So we can view the encrypted holo recording. Well, where do I have to view it at? Oh. Yeah, because it really depends, because, like, it might be a certain size at some point, and then at another point in time, it might be different due to, like, you know, you don't know what the recent patch was downloaded. I don't know how patching a game works. I don't know if it's, like, constantly adding more and more data, or if a patch is, like, it won't add it as much. Like, it'd be like putting a patch on clothing, like you're just putting something over it, but it's still the same, like the piece of clothing isn't bigger, right? So, I'm not really sure. I mean, it's free on Steam, because, like, you could just, like, I know the launcher doesn't take too long to download, I'm pretty sure, but even if it, like, you download it all on this, when you download it on Steam, I guess you could technically figure it out that way, because it won't cost you anything to get it in your Steam library. Although, I could probably see how much space it takes in, because I'd imagine, I don't know if it's a thing, maybe, like, you can see how much a file is taking by mousing over it on, when you're, like, mousing over the file. Okay. Cool. Few more people to get rid of. Yeah, I'll do that after I'm done, and I'll message you how big it is. Yeah, I remember you said you like writing and stuff. I was like, oh, I want to tell him about, like, my game setting, because I figured, I don't know, it'd be kind of cool if, like, you wrote, like, stories and stuff, because I'm not smart enough to write. I have a hard enough time reading.
You're such a cynical guy. Can't I just be paying an old friend a visit?
You and friends is the funniest thing I've heard all year. Get to the point before I stop laughing.
Long man from the outer rim is sticking to me like a Minock on a power coupling. I need somebody to scrape him off.
Lawman, huh? Sounds like that'll cost you double.
Whatever it takes. Look, I'm in a rush to wrap up with the business here. Besides, find a word for my friends makes me feel good.
Nice. So where is this little parasite you want me to remove?
He's at a docking bay in the spaceport, and he's alone. I'm sure he won't give a burly scrapper like you much trouble.
I guarantee he won't. Oh, and I'll be wanting my payment in advance.
I wouldn't have it any other way, Urbax. You enjoy yourself.
It might be this lawman knows how to find Skarik. We'd better try to save him. Let's go bust up that party at the spaceport, Captain.
Alright. But yeah, I figured you'd probably want to write your own thing, though. But I figured I'd tell you about my thing, unless you... I guess in case you thought it was interesting or not. Alright. Let's intercept and return to Nam-K. I can do that. There we go. And then I just need to go back to the spaceport. So. Let's go here. Oh, okay. I need to make sure I remember to, after this stream's done, to also just replace my thing. About your writing? Yeah, I was, it was what I messaged you in the Discord, because I was like, oh, I wonder if, like, Kaiju, would like the, all the stuff I, because, like, I don't have anything about my personal homebrew setting, like, written down, but it's just all in my head, right? But, I just wanted to, at some point, like, just tell you about it in case, like, you ever, I don't know, if you thought it was interesting. I don't know, maybe you can, like, make money off of my own imagination. I don't know, I think that would be cool. Well, although you'd probably, I was just also saying that you probably want to focus on your own creation, though. Because I know you're trying to, like, you said you're trying to, like, write some kind of story or something. Alright, it's another smuggler phase. Let's go save this police officer. Right. Yeah, I don't know. I think you should probably, if you're writing it, if you were to write it, I don't know. I wouldn't mind getting, like, a small percentage, but if you're doing all the work, you should get more, I think. I'd just be happy enough getting just a tiny bit, you know? Oh, you're writing a Western. Oh, okay, that's cool. Yeah, because I know for, like, my homebrew setting that I like to run fantasy TTRPGs in, if I do a setting most of the time, I kind of like my inspiration is, like, imagine if, like, you fused C.S. Lewis's world with Tolkien's world, and I think, like, that would be a really cool type of setting.
This was fun, little mouse, but we're done playing. Time to die. I can't figure out if this Sullustan's deaf or just stupid.
All of you against one guy? That's overkill, don't you think?
I told you idiots to watch that door. Do I have to do everything myself? You don't belong in here, little girlie. Better leave before you break a nail.
Is there a reason you're whining to me about it?
Okay.
Alright.
We'll do this one for free, I think.
You heard the man, lawbreakers. Surrender now, or else.
You really are as dumb as you look, aren't you? Kill them both, men.
Okay, well, time to put this shotgun at the back of your head and just pull the trigger. There we go. Where, are they already all dead? Oh, wow. I'm grateful for your assistance. Okay. Yeah, it's no problemo. Weird creature.
Sticking up for the little guy is what I do best.
Yeah. I ain't nobody special.
I was just passing through when I heard the commotion.
You have any backup?
Can't you get the Republic to lend a hand?
Yeah, it's an interesting theory.
I guess you could be right.
Yeah, okay, yeah, we can do that.
I'll take any help I can get.
Yeah, don't tell them anything about me, though.
Keep my name out of that report, all right?
Let's not be here when the local security shows up. We don't have time to answer questions. Maybe we should go see if Darmus knows anything new about Skavik.
Okay. So now... Wait, Darmus... Wait a minute, what's going on? Well, I do know I need to go to the Senate building. Let's just go to the Senate Tower. Seems like it'd be the closest place. Gotta talk to the Senate about those water pipes we fixed. Gotta fix the plumbing in Coruscant.
All Coruscant systems indicate clean life waters flow upward. You flawlessly applied my crafted solution to the hydro supply at the Black Sun level below. Adulation.
Yeah, I always enjoy a good fight.
Taking down Black Sun thugs was a lot of fun.
You took yellow equilateral to the green perpendicular? That is profoundly appropriate. My seared chassis feels justified. Clean life waters flow and nurture upper levels. The Coruscant sufferer beings achieve benefits on the Enclave's green ingenuity. My black sphere evolves to a purple parallel because of you. When I impart this development, Patake will progress enthusiasm with the Senator.
Yeah, well, time to hand over my reward.
I did what you wanted, now pay up.
You exhibit numerous disagreeable traits, but black bisectors often do. I pledged you a piece of Gree ingenuity. This solution was crafted specifically for your being. My acknowledgement and appreciations. I continue upgrading Coruscant systems and ensure the clean life waters flow upward. Accept my unyielding gratefulness.
Alright. Oh, nice. He's given us a belt of some kind. Okay.
That ought to fix you.
Is there some way I can pitch in?
Operator units always inherit fouled labors. I administrate as well as Patake, but I am marooned to waste processing. What have I done to incur white acute?
Waste processing. Operator units.
Is that what you are? An operator unit?
You submit curiosity. Bewildering. Foreign species customarily embody flawless self-centeredness. Gree units fulfill four caste assignments. Crafter, operator, researcher, and administrator. I am operator. I ensure proper function of Gree ingenuity. Patake is administrator unit. His sole aptitude is communication command governance argument. I can serve Patake's function. Can he serve mine? No.
So I'm bitter about it.
If you dislike your assignment so much, why not change to a different one?
My aptitudes are Gray Sphere, but the Enclave permits only operator unit assignment. This is an equitable distribution of my aptitudes. Patake commanded me. Optimize Coruscant's waste processing system. Preserve your organs from filth, disease, poisons. But Ugnaught Porcine bipeds plunder Gree ingenuity from waste processors. With Gree optimization solution stolen, filth, disease, poisons spread uncontrolled, plagues imminent.
Well, so why don't you just fix it?
Replace whatever was stolen and stop wasting my time.
Replacing Gree ingenuity forbidden under Enclave Code Law. Optimization solution must be repossessed. The Ugnaught Porcine bipeds plundered Gree optimization solution unaware of internal transmitters. I detect the plundered device's coordinates. Patake authorizes compensation of Republic credits to the Black Bisector who repossesses the optimization solution.
We can count their ass grass.
I'm itching for some live target practice.
That is the expected response, Black Bisector. Why exhaust respiratory functions on it?
Okay. Alright, now we gotta go talk to Darmos. I wonder, like, he ought to be at that cantina in this, was it? Steeler's Den Cantina. Yeah, let's go there. Because clearly, the one guy, our little contact dude, is gonna be over here. Because he's always at this cantina. Stealing people's, playing cards and taking people's money.
Darmos says this is the best watering hole on the planet.
See? What'd I tell you? It's the captain from Rogue on the Butcher's bounty posting. Are we lucky or what?
I never doubted you for a second, lover. You've always been my lucky star.
Ugh, you two make me sick. Hold it right there, Captain.
I don't answer to retarded people.
Is that a hairstyle? Or did a womp rat die on your head?
Did you just... Shut up! Come on, you two. Let's cremate this fool and get rich.
Alright, well, this is a boring conversation. Let's get started.
I love killing morons like you.
Yeah.
Let's burn it up!
I mean, if you're dumber than me... I just need to get rid of you, because I can only be the dumbest person. There can only be one dumb person, and that's me. Okay. Well, that problem's been solved. This kind of helped clean out the gene pool. Doing God's work. Alright.
Having some trouble with bounty hunters, Captain?
Only a little.
Oh, I can't help it if I'm popular with all the wrong people.
Don't sell yourself short, my dear. All the right people find you charming, too.
I hear Black Sun's on an emergency recruitment drive, and you had an altercation at the spaceport. I take it my lead was worthwhile.
Yeah, I'm just tightening the noose on Skavik.
Skavik will be right
about to kick him off the chair.
That's quite the vicious streak. It seems he brings out the worst in people.
While we wait for Skavik to make his next move, perhaps we could play a little sabacc?
I saw that one coming.
Orzo, don't be such a spoil sport. What do you say, Captain? First game's on me.
It's the two of us, huh?
I was hoping we'd have a chance to get better acquainted.
That sounds delightful. I'd love to hear all about you, my dear.
I may have been a bit hasty when I said we could trust Darmos.
Yeah, but what if the captain Was it Schoonachu? I forget what I named my character. But maybe she likes wrinkles.
I prefer a man with some life experience.
Right. I, think I'll leave you two alone.
Yeah, get out of here, loser.
I'll just put a do not disturb sign outside so we can talk as long as we like.
Yeah, let's go play some fucking Yu-Gi-Oh! Or something.
Well, that was highly informative. I'm already looking forward to our future discussions.
Yeah, me too. There won't be any. Well, back to business.
Sorry, but there's only one thing on my mind right now.
Yeah, let's go play Yu-Gi-Oh! Again. Let's
yes,
play more cards.
I see you're eager to continue your other manhunt.
Yeah. Fucking, our captain's hunting for men.
I'm receiving an alert from my network. This may be what we've been waiting for. Looks like your efforts have paid off, Captain. My informants just witnessed Skavik fighting someone and fleeing into Justicar's territory. We have him.
All right. Justicars.
Who are these Justicars?
The Vigilantes, self-appointed judges of a whole city sector. Executioners is more like it. The Justicars don't tolerate outsiders in their sector. Skavik must truly be desperate to risk his life going there.
Alright. Well, I want him first. This is a competition now. Who can kill Skavik the fastest, since I'm gonna win.
I'm not letting some Justicar kill Skavik before I do.
Then you'd better hurry. Justicars aren't known for their mercy. My informants are a brother and sister named Jik and Jewel. They know where to find Skavik. I'll tell them you're coming. Play your hand carefully in the Justicar sector. My instincts tell me Skavik hasn't shown all his cards yet.
Alright, well, thank you. It helped a lot.
You've been a real prince, Darmus. I won't forget it.
I hope this isn't the last we'll see of each other. I can't help feeling there's more to our relationship than revenge on Skavik.
Like what?
You think a starship captain like me and a gambler like you would ever work out?
Why not? I think we complement each other well.
Good luck to you, Captain. I hope you make Skavik pay all his debts.
Yeah. Neato. Alright, well, we don't have any new gear that's worth equipping. So we gotta speak to some guy called Jewel, and then there's the Greek one where, Gree, not Greek. No, let me teleport again, I think. That'll move things way faster. I don't want to teleport to the cantina, but how do I... Well, I guess I can just go to the Black Sun sector and then use the taxi over there to get to where I need to go.
Vehicle pads are currently open for business. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
And I think there's like the Justicar area. I'm pretty sure there's like also there's the Jedi Temples area. But in like order to get to the Jedi Temple, you have to like go through this sewer area that's through the Justicar area, from what I remember. I think that's how the planet layout works. The order of things. Alright. Time to head off. So, we just gotta talk to someone over here. Oh yeah, we gotta speak to the detective, I think. Maybe that's who's standing over here. Going on. I'm getting targeted by someone. I don't think they're going to be able to catch us, though. Alright. Where are you, Jewel? There you are. Oh, no, this isn't the detective person. Well, who are you?
The captain, right? About time you got here. Thanks to you, the Justicar snagged my brother, Jick. Should have never tangled ourselves in your cloud-head business.
Back up and start over.
Kid, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Typical Cloudhead. Don't know which way is up unless a turfer explains it. Listen hard and wise up. I'm Jewel. My brother Jick and I were watching Skavik for you. Big mistake. Nothing but trouble. Things always go bad for turfers when Cloudheads come down here. Never should have took this job.
Give me information.
I got problems of my own. Just tell me where Skavik is.
You get yours and us turfers take care of ourselves, right? Wrong. Now you get to work like us. Jick and I were tailing Skavik when the Justicars came after us. Jick stuck to Skavik. I drew the Justicars. I lost those helmet brains easy, but they snagged Jick and hauled him off to their detention center.
Alright, well maybe I can help you.
I could lend a hand if you need one.
Like you have a choice. Our bad luck is your bad luck. Jick knows where Skavik went, but he didn't have time to spill it to me before they snagged him. You want Skavik? Better prowl into the Justicar's detention center and free my brother.
Alright. Just like that, huh?
Jailbreaks aren't exactly easy, kid.
Like I don't know that? But listen, I got an idea how to do it. Once inside the detention center, you have to bash all the Justicar droid eyes. That's how they track intruders. If those droid eyes aren't rubble, the Justicars will know your face. You don't want that.
No, they don't worry me.
If those idiots want my face on file, they're welcome to it.
You want a price on your head? Fine. But Jick's in enough trouble. I don't want the Justicars coming after him again. Don't just stand there goggling at me. Get Jick out of that detention center before something happens to him.
Alright. On one condition.
If I do this, you have to stop calling me a Cloudhead.
Don't bet on it. Take this holotransmitter with you. I want to talk to Jake as soon as you free him.
All right. Where is this other person now? Okay, they're over there. Man, I don't know why I feel so tired right now. I just feel exhausted. Alright, looks like we go through here, okay. But yeah, I've been having, I had fun doing all the new Final Fantasy XIV content. And, I need to do the roulettes again just so I can upgrade all the Manderville weapons. And the next one I'm gonna get is the Paladin. Just because that's really the only tank I know how to play at the moment. And I'm hoping my friend can, like, teach me how to play Warrior. So what I'm probably gonna do is, then after I get the Paladin weapon, I wanna just get the Warrior weapon just so I can not feel bad about, or I don't even know if I should get the Warrior one, or if I should get the, or Sage or something, or even the samurai weapon, because I want to be able to do, like, one type of roll at the very least. Actually, I know what I want to get after, I either want to get the samurai one, or I want to get the machinist, weapon, I think. Get, like, a nice, hand cannon of some kind, or a nice katana. But I'm looking forward to getting my paladin weapon upgrade, because, I know that I saw someone with the paladin weapon, and I thought it looked really cool. Oh, this is with the Ugnaughts. I didn't realize I was heading toward here. I want the greed device.
You know why I'm here.
Yeah, I'm still waiting for the device.
I don't have to listen to this load of garbage.
Yeah, I fucking hate the Senate. The Republic's gay.
This is Coruscant. Why wouldn't the Senate help with repairs?
The Empire doesn't have this much incompetence.
Don't worry about the odds so much.
Fine, I'll help you, you dumb little pig man.
I'll tell the Gree representatives about your situation.
Hey, well, that's all I had to do was just let them know. I'll tell the Gree about the filters not working. Well, that's easy. Like, why wouldn't I tell them? That would, like, give me an extra reward, probably. Because those pig people will reward me, and then the Gree will reward me. For doing the job I already said I was gonna do. Ah! Ooh, man. I gotta do this. I'm trying to think of what I'm gonna play tomorrow. I mean, I either want to play Hogwarts Legacy or Fallout. Or not Fallout. Yeah, Fallout 1. But I'm not sure. I'll probably do Hogwarts Legacy, I guess. I don't know, it was weird though. Like, I don't know, it's like every time, I don't know if it's like the same person. But I think like someone's hate watching my Hogwarts stuff. Maybe some weird cultist of some kind that is part of that type of the blue cult or whatever. Maybe they get mad at that I'm playing the game or whatever. I don't know. I just want to, like, dislike every video I do for Hogwarts Legacy or whatever. It's like, well, I mean, I don't know how to tell this person, though, but, like, the fact that I'm pissing someone off by playing it is, like, kind of worth more than a like on the video is to me, honestly, so I don't know what to tell them. They're just kind of, like, making me actually feel better. But it was like, oh, okay. I mean, it's cool that I'm actually pissing someone off on the internet, I guess. Having fun playing a silly Wizards game. Although, I don't really, like, I don't know. I remember me and my friends were talking about this, but, like, the only reason, because, like, the developers were never, because the developers are probably, like, part of the Blue Cult as well. Right? Like, they're never, like, our guys, right? But, I only bought it, not that I fucking cared or liked the developers at all, but I only bought it after, like, they were all making a big deal about it. It's like, man, I just want to watch you see the even more. I'm going to buy it. In fact, I'm going to buy one of my friends a copy as well. So I actually bought two of them, because I remember I bought my friend Rap the game, I think, and I bought myself the game. I'm pretty sure that's what I did. He might have bought it himself. I just remember buying, two of them. Okay, that's what we're looking for. We're looking for cameras to blast. I don't know where the cameras are, though. Oh, there's the camera. These cameras are a bit kind of hard to see. But, like, even when that game came out, Hogwarts Legacy, like, I remember there's, like, I forget what the VTuber's name is. I think her name was, like, Silver Veil or anything. I forgot what her... It's like, she's, like, weird, some weird person. I don't know. But she was getting all... She was, like, acted all surprised that, like, all these people were attacking her for playing the game. And it's like... I'm like, oh, you're surprised this has happened with the audience you fucking catered... You catered to, essentially. You know? It's like, you're surprised that they're, trying... Like, the alligator... is trying to eat you now, essentially, and it's like, you know, like, I feel like, that one broad got what she fucking deserved, honestly. Like, I could really care less that she was getting attacked, because it's like, well, you kind of deserve what you fucking get, you know? And, like, I remember a lot of those, like, those freaking super woke, like, people were getting attacked, and they're like, oh... I remember there's, like, this other channel, it was, like, him, and it's, like, I think it's this channel where him and his girlfriend will play stuff, but they were, like, I think, well, I felt a little bad for them, because they're, like, a couple and stuff, but, like, part of me didn't feel bad, because they're also, like, super woke, and, like, they were, like, acting all surprised that, you know, this audience they catered to was attacking them as well, and it's, like, yeah, like, at least for my channel... I don't fucking care about those type of people. In fact, like, I'm not gonna cater toward fucking anybody. Like, I just wanna do what I wanna do. Right? I wanna just have fun. Like, I don't know. I don't care what... Like, I don't fucking care what, like, people... like, have a problem. Like, if I'm having fun doing something, I don't care if every video gets, like, 100 dislikes. I'm still gonna fucking do it because I'm having fun. You know, like, I don't, like, why would I care what people think of me online? Alright, shoot this guy now. The thing that inspires me to do things is, mainly just having fun, but, like, in certain cases, I just want to just, like, make people like that in regards to that video game. I just like making them cope and seethe. Because, like, apparently I'm some kind of, like, sadist of some kind. Alright. Enough about fucking the silly wizard game, though. Yeah, I do. I kind of want to play that now, tomorrow. Hopefully I can, whoever's doing that to my stuff, I can, keep on making them angrier. Little levels. It's hard for me to spot these cameras. Okay, it looks like there's a camera over here. I'm hoping these cameras, like, respawn and they're not, like, an individual camera for each one, right? Alright, we got five of them. Okay, there's another one over here. Man, I can't wait till I can just have my, my space doge follow me around instead of the current follower I have. Because I'd rather just have the dog. It's just like all the fucking cuts, the smuggler story cutscenes on this planet require that I have Corso Riggs with me, and it's like, I'd rather have my dog, or my little space dog with me. Be like a fucking Shaggy and Scooby-Doo in space. You know, I'm convinced, by the way, in regards to Scooby-Doo. I don't think Scooby-Doo was ever a talking guy, or a talking dog. I think, what was happening was, is that Shaggy was so baked and high on every single episode of Scooby-Doo that it was just all on fucking Shaggy's head, right? Like, Shaggy was just high in every episode, and that's why Scooby could talk. But really, Shaggy's probably in some kind of, like, he's either just always baked or he's, like, in a mental insane asylum. And, yeah, that's what I think's going on in Scooby-Doo. I just think Shaggy's high is constantly. And here's the last, camera, I think. Alright, let's go blast this last camera. Okay, so where am I going? That's the Ugnaught Saboteurs. Okay. Okay, so we gotta go through this phase. Okay. Why are you in jail?
I take it you met the Justicars.
You fought Skavik?
Did you at least manage to wound him?
You look a little beat up.
Have they hurt you?
Might as well spring the little fellow while we're here.
Yeah, you got it, bud.
Don't worry, I won't leave you in there.
Yeah, I like this guy's species and just the way their voices sounds. Some reason it reminds me of, like, people speaking, like, typically, like, Chinese or Vietnamese. Whenever they talk. Alright, yeah, don't mention it.
Get out of here before the Justicars come back.
Okay, let's grab this kid.
I feel like my insides are coming out.
Yeah, well, your sister sent me.
On your feet, chick. Let's get you out of here.
You're definitely not a Justicar. All they ever called me was gutter scum.
Okay, gutter snipe. Let's
chick,
get you out.
It's me, Jewel. Are you all right? What did those Justicars do to you?
Hey, sis. Knew you wouldn't forget about me. Who's the Cloudhead?
The Captain Darmus asked us to help. What happened when you followed Skavik? How come the Justicar snagged you?
Saw something I wasn't supposed to. You won't believe this, but I caught the Justicars trading supplies with the Empire.
Oh, that's a strange friendship.
How could that be? It doesn't seem possible.
Some Turfers think a few Imperials stayed behind after the war ended. I always thought it was just stories to scare the kids.
Skavik and the Imperials were laughing about something. I'm not sure what. The Imperials took Skavik into the works.
Alright, well, tell me about the works.
I've never heard of this place. What's it like?
It's a big mess of power stations and old factories below us. I didn't think anything could survive down there except droids. If Skavik dropped to the works, you may as well go home. You wouldn't last 5 minutes.
We're pretty good. Bet we last 10 minutes.
The works is nothing but toxic runes and berserk droids. People who go down there don't come back.
Well, I'll come back.
I'll do it blindfolded, just for fun.
Been nice knowing you, I guess.
I'd like to go home now. This is the worst party I've ever been to.
All right.
Crawl in and come to the warehouse. I'll hide you from the Justicars.
Great. I'm gonna smell like Rancor droppings for a week. Thanks for busting me out, Captain.
Alright. No problemo.
You did good, kid.
Kid? I'm almost as old as you.
Chick, take my holotransmitter from the Captain before you leave. I'm not letting you out of my sight.
Don't be so dramatic. There's only a little torture. Good luck down in the works, Captain. You'll need it.
So nice new t-shirt she gave me. Neato.
You're all right.
We're level 26. Neat. Okay, so now we gotta go through here, and both the Ugnaught Saboteurs and the thing for Skavik's down here, so. Aw, man, you know what? I wish I could play, because I just remembered something from my childhood, speaking of Scooby-Doo and stuff. I remember it was, like, this old, it might have been for either the Nintendo 64 or the PlayStation 1, maybe? But, it was, like, this Scooby-Doo game, where you just, like, you know, are solve, like, you go solve mysteries as, like, Shaggy or something, and I don't know, that would be kind of interesting to play. Like a really old Scooby-Doo game. And that could be a lot of fun. I'm gonna not stealth, and we will get on our... on our... vehicle. Really? Yeah, I hope he doesn't... Okay, good. He's not gonna knock us off. Ugh. Oh no. Yeah, I'm probably gonna get knocked off here. Maybe I'm gonna be lucky. Maybe I'm gonna luck out. Yeah! ...20% luck, 30% luck ...95% luck More percentages of luck. We're just all made out of luck. Oh no, I spoke too soon! No. I just jinxed myself. Maybe I'm just like 200% made out of pain. I gotta remember the name. Alright, well, I'll just, Corso distract him. Let's run off and skedaddle on out of here. Ugh. Well, I think we're out of all the combat areas now. We just gotta turn in, repair a Gree console of some kind. And then, I guess, go down an elevator. And I'm trying to think of what I wanna do on Saturday. I know my schedule's been all jumbled this week because I haven't been playing all the same games that I normally play on those designated days.
Internal transmitters reveal you convey.
And I don't know if I want to do anything on Saturday. In fact, I'm not. I kind of want to. Part of me wants to probably designate Saturday as like a day off for where I can just do whatever I want. And kind of just have a day off, which would be nice, instead of doing, like, working every day, I guess, on the channel. It would be nice to have at least one day off. Yeah, freaks should work together.
You're all a bunch of weirdos. I'm sure you'll get along great.
The Ugnaught porcine bipeds express similar disgruntlement with your species. This describes a foundation for collaboration. With this optimization solution repossessed, Coruscant's waste processors revive. Filth disease poison levels recede. Plague outbreaks averted. All resolves to purple parallel.
Nice. Okay, so. Oh, he's back.
The black bisector comes. Pleasing as it is needed. I am NIK, science unit. Please talk up if you're...
Oh, I thought you were the same person. All you robots look the same.
Language words to help you understand.
No, I just want to move on. No time for chatting.
Let's cut to the chase.
All apologies. We should obliterate small talk now and move forward. Padake has planted information inside you. But I am the most powerful power overseer. And responsibility for darkness is mine. Coruscant power comes from the works. Darkness comes from the works. Coruscant senators, traitors are blind. The power darkness must stop.
Alright. Yeah, lousy whining senators.
Politicians and merchants are always complaining. I wouldn't worry about it.
Complainants in the Enclave meld into the Ochre Tetrasphere. Not so on Coruscant, alas. The works is very low on Coruscant. There, Gree-spawning generators breed electrons for machine consumption, but enemy droid machines intersect the power conduits and yellow shift their functionality. Enemy droid machines must stop, and conduits must be fixed.
Alright, we'll go on.
What's your plan for making that happen?
I monitor the power conduits, and know where to implement purple shifting. As Black Bisector, you can take out many, many droid machines. With information planted inside you, and our Toolsphere repair mother in your many fingers, you can perform the fixing function. Is it efficacious?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Sounds efficacious to me.
Excellent. Red tangents envelop us. You will do well, Black Bisector.
Alright, ooh, we now got some new boots. Some new fancy shoes. Alrighty. Then I think you get like a title for helping those Gree robot people. I think it's like of the Black Bisector or something. I mean, I don't know what it means being of the Black Bisector. I don't know what a Black Bisector is, but it sounds pretty cool. I'll give it that. Man, it is just so nice being able to use stealth, you know? It's, you know, it's just not being able to be seen when you don't want to be seen, just walking past people and taking their stuff without them knowing until it's too late for them. Man, I must feel pretty good. Alright, so, gotta get all these power conduits, it seems. Alright, well, let's go break these robots. Just push all their buttons until they break. Have some kind of error. Alrighty. I wonder what my outfit kind of looks like without the gear. Show gear's outfit. This is what I look like normally. Okay. Well, I want to be in my outfit because I think it looks cooler than what I'm wearing. Like, actually wearing. Oh, man. I just kind of realized yesterday. Because, like, I kind of remember there was, like, that thing Elon Musk was working on. Where, like, you get the weird thing put in your brain, right? And, it, like, when people had that done to them, the, like, it'll fix their, like, if they're paralyzed, right? That chip thing would help them be able to walk again, because it would, like, with the chip did a weird thing to where it would help with things if, like, you had nerve damage, and that's kind of, like, what would happen if you're paralyzed, right? And I know with the thing I'm sick with is a broken nerve that is in my neck area. I mean, your spine has to, like, go through your neck, right? I would imagine.
Marusta Van Ruten.
Oh, wait, hold on a minute.
It's even more exquisite than I imagined. This will be the perfect centerpiece for my gift to the Grand Moff.
Sure to learn you a nice fad promotion. Maybe the Grand Moff will finally let you go home to Droman Kaas.
What's your tone, Skavak? My agent is standing by at the spaceport ready to deliver the item. You have someone ready to receive it?
There's a twitchy little starship merchant named Fabazan in my docking bay. He'll accept my payment.
Lieutenant, transmit the signal. I don't know what you want with that grotesque trophy, Skavak, but it's all yours now.
Need any other priceless relics, Commander? Just let me know.
Sorry, you're out of business, Skavak.
Your thieving days are over, Skavak.
Too much to ask that someone guard the entrance to our secret base.
Captain, seriously, I admire your persistence, but this is ridiculous.
Skavak, is this thing a friend of yours?
Yeah.
But you know aliens, Commander. Always popping up where they don't belong.
Yeah, Italians are like a type of alien, right? We pop up everywhere where we don't belong.
Florstein, we're
dumb.
We're good at getting in places we don't belong.
I heard about your job. Hey, don't let unemployment make you bitter, all right? You're the one who followed up my identity record and sent half the galaxy chasing me? That wasn't very nice, Captain.
Well, I mean, what are friends for, Skavik?
That's the least I could do for you, old pal.
You know, holding on to anger like that will give you health problems. Framing me with the crime scene.
You say that, but I always use my anger to do stuff productive.
Oh, wait, that's right. You do. I heard Rogan the Butcher just raised the price on your head. Congratulations.
Enough of this. The captain is your problem, Skavak. Deal with it.
Commander, would you mind vaporizing the captain for me? I've got places to be.
Skavak! Blast that scoundrel, always leaving me to clean up his messes.
Well, so don't then.
You could just let me go.
No, and I'm afraid you won't be leaving here. We'll give you a very nice, unmarked grave. What do you think you are giving me orders? You're as good as dead, you alien filth.
Yeah, give him a break.
He's just doing his job, Commander.
Spare me your false heroics. Men, kill this alien scum.
Oh no. Oh no, they shot him. We gotta help him. We gotta get a, like, put a fucking stim pack up his butt and heal him. Oh, I thought the commander was dead. Well, let's backhand him real quick. There we go, he's dead. Got the gem. Hang on, don't say that.
We'll get you to a Colto tank.
Poor little guy. He didn't deserve to go out like this.
No, he's dead. I don't remember him dying. That's dumb. Gotta throw him in a Colto tank. I don't think Bacta was invented yet. But they had Colto. But I know when Bacta was invented, Colto just went out of business. Some Bacta juice. Gotta like go into the future. Grab some Bacta juice and then stick them in it. Okay. So throw that there. Oh, we ended up missing this other power conduit. Well, that's annoying. Alright, well, just hurry up and drive over here. And then we gotta use the works taxi. Because I think in order to even use the taxi to get into the Jedi Temple. Oh, why am I not moving? Oh, okay, that was weird. But, in order to even, like, fly to the Jedi Temple, I think afterwards you can use any taxi. I'm pretty certain. But, at least the first time, you gotta use the taxi in here in order to get to the Jedi Temple in Coruscant. So, at least I remember it being that way. I could be wrong. I could have, like, changed it or something. Or maybe it was never that way. And it was, like, just in my head the whole time that I had to do that. Start hiding. Okay, looks like we can just go up here and then go around and then blow up that final conduit.
happy to be in the works. Guess we're even.
Alrighty. Although I'm curious as to if I can, just, you know, I want to check that out. I'm actually going to teleport out of here and see if I can just fly directly to the, Jedi Temple. Because I might as well see if it's a thing. So, let's, teleport to here. And then let's see if we, when we take the flight path, or hold on a minute, we might as well turn in this Black Sector quest here. Because then we don't have to worry about any more quests, like side objectives on Coruscant, right? And just focus on the story. And luckily the robots aren't on the second floor, which is nice, because the second floor is just really takes a long time to get anywhere in the Senate building on Coruscant. I just hate Coruscant though, because like you gotta go in this building every time for the story quest for all the classes on the Republic. But you can't even mount. And the building's so huge that, like, because, like, on, at least in Drummond Cost, like, none of the buildings are this huge. So, like, even if you can't mount somewhere, the building's small enough to where it won't take you, like, 12 years to go anywhere.
And I have witnessed through our monitors. Also, you destroyed many enemy droid machines. So, well done.
Alright, so it's all over?
Coruscant's power supply is safe? No more blackouts?
No, not eternally. In one millennium, if our interests intersect, we will ask for help again. Please remember, Gree technology is exclusive to the Enclave. Do not attempt to duplicate, or you will be absorbed into the Great Pentacheron.
Okay. So, who do I talk to now? Just talk to you?
Black Bisector returns prosperous.
Alright, I just wanna... I don't care anymore. I'm done. Give me my money. Okay, we got a helmet. It was Black Bisector. Okay, well, why don't we use one of those XP buffs? That would be a smart idea. Okay, still can't move. Or can't mount. Just waddle on out as fast as we can, as our small little legs will take us. Should be able to get on our thing now. Here we go. What is this? The spaceport central elevator. Wait, do smugglers don't have any reason to go to the Jedi Temple? Ooh, interesting. Well, maybe I'm almost done with the Coruscant now. Well, that's neat. We've only been playing for like an hour and a half. I could probably do the whole Hammer Station thing then. More than likely then right after this, once we get our spaceship. Let's go back to the to the Republic Space Command area and do a little dungeon, and then I think we'll be done for the day, maybe. You're never done with Coruscant? Yeah, it feels like Coruscant is always causing problems. Alright. Race the devil, there we go. Slice into Docking Bay 87.
Jeez, Kakava Coyota. Do Bando Bakawonki.
Not anymore.
It's my docking bay now.
Sancho Naga.
Time to die, Fazabane. You're in the wrong place at the wrong time. So throw a grenade at him and then wound him a bit to where he's bleeding. And then start punching. Keeping the pimp hand strong. That's the play style we play. You're a salesman?
That just means you're an even bigger thief than Skavik.
Not yet. But you owe the captain something for all her trouble.
Now show me all you got. Give me everything for free, and also screw over Skavik, and you got a deal. You'll be allowed to live.
What are my options?
Alright. Yeah, well, I'm a man of my word. Get out of here.
Beat it before I shoot you.
Yeah, I should have killed him. Maybe he's gonna let Skavik know I took the ship. Maybe I shouldn't have left any witnesses. I love the smuggler ship the most because it looks exactly like the Millennium Falcon. And the story started that someone just stole our ship, and now we got our ship back. And I believe chapter one is like trying to hunt down for some like space treasure or something. That's a whole storyline for act one. Like the reason I love the smuggler storyline is just it's like the most non-serious story ever. It's just like you fucking around and goofing off in space, basically. And that's the smuggler storyline in a nutshell. Time to get off this horrible planet. All right. Oh wait, there's someone we gotta talk to on our ship. Okay.
I expected to be the only woman on this ship. Are you one of Skavik's special friends?
You're on my ship, lady.
This freighter and everything in it belongs to me, lady. That's so. What an exciting development. My name's Risha. I've been traveling with Skavik as part of a business arrangement. He and I had a deal to deliver the things you see here.
Interesting. Well, tell me about what this deal you had.
Now I'm all ears. Keep talking. Skavik was going to deliver this cargo, but he's proving unreliable. I think you might be a much better partner.
I am open to making some money.
Let's hear your offer and we'll see. My offer is simple. I make you filthy rich. It's a pretty straightforward business model. What do you know? That's Skavik on the ship's hollow. This should be an interesting conversation.
I don't want to actually answer. I'm just going to...
You're late, Skavik. And I just made a new friend. I think you two will loathe each other.
Congratulations, Captain. You're officially number one on my list of people to kill. When I get my hands on you, you'll wish you'd never left Ord Mantell.
Oh, you're breaking up. Alright, best of luck.
Have fun with that.
You don't even know what you've stumbled into, Captain. You're messing up a deal I spent months putting together. I don't know how you got away from those Imperials, but next time, I'll kill you myself. Assuming Rogan the Butcher doesn't get you first. I sold all those blasters you were supposed to deliver for him on Ord Mantell. I can't imagine he'll be happy that you lost them.
He doesn't scare me.
He'll be even less happy after I fry him.
You honestly think you can kill someone like Rogan the Butcher? Where do you get these delusions?
I don't see why I couldn't. I mean, it's probably easy to kill as everyone else I killed. To deliver.
Don't even think about cutting me out of this deal, Risha.
Finders keepers. Isn't that what you always say? Not my fault the captain here beat you to the big prize.
Sweetheart, you two just made the biggest mistake of your lives.
There you go. He's finally leaving us alone.
So, we were discussing how I can make you fabulously wealthy.
Yeah.
The items here are pieces to a key. A key that unlocks the lost treasure of a very rich dead man named Nocdrayan.
I seem to have heard of Nocdrayan. Yeah, rich, huh?
Now you're speaking my language. Just wait. It gets better. Nocdrayan was the greatest gangster who ever lived. He personally wiped out the Wrath Cartel and the Vandalhelm Combine during the Syndicate Wars. When he died 10 years ago, Nock had more wealth than some Outer Rim worlds. Even the Hutts were jealous.
Where'd all his money go? I want it all.
What happened to Nock's fortune after he died? Now we're getting to the interesting part. Nock hid his fortune right before he died. For 10 years, treasure hunters across the galaxy have searched for it in vain. Until now. You see, I've finally figured out how to get the lost riches of Nocdrayan.
Yeah, I mean, let's go find this, like, Star Wars version of, like, Confederate gold. Well, tell me how.
What have you figured out? I know better than to just give up my secrets, Captain. Whoever gets Nock's riches will become an underworld legend. Skavik had his chance and blew it. Now it's your turn.
I'm already an underworld legend.
Cargo hold, and Nocdrayan's wealth will be all yours.
All mine?
What are you getting out of this? I'm after something personal. The money doesn't mean anything to me, Captain. I'm the only one that can help you trade these items to get Nocdrayan's treasure. But I won't tell you everything up front. To get the riches, you trust me the same way I trust you. One step at a time.
Yeah, deal. Fine. Alright, that sounds like a deal.
You had me at riches. Then let's hit the hyperlanes. We have deals set up on Taris and Nar Shaddaa. I'll make all the arrangements and introductions for you on both planets. Until then, I'll be in my bunk. That caged beast there isn't much good for conversation, so come visit me if you feel like chatting.
Alright, well, I'll do that then.
I'm sure you have some good stories about Skavik. Enough to make you glad you never dated him. Looking forward to working with you, Captain.
Neat. Okay. Alright, well, let's go fly off to, apparently we can talk to, corso.
So, how'd you end up out here, Captain? Was there ever a time you wanted something more normal? A husband? Kids? Someone to take care of you?
No.
I take care of myself. Always have, always will.
I'm not trying to start anything, Captain. Just thinking about a guy I met in the brigade. A merc. Fought for the Republic for 20 years. I was 16, fresh off the ship. This guy gave me my first blaster.
Yeah, your first blaster, huh?
I thought you country boys grow up shooting.
I mean, sure, I'd handled a hunting rifle, but never anything aimed at people. This guy told me, gun's just a tool. You use it to destroy, or you use it to protect against those who would destroy you.
Yeah? I guess it meant a lot to you then.
And you took it to heart.
Made me think different about guns. You can't protect the people you love if you're afraid to get your hands dirty. I brought Torchy home, and my parents made me lock her up. Told me not to wish away peace. I didn't have her when the Separatists came.
Alrighty. Looks like he has something more to say.
Boy, Captain. Life with you is almost enough to get me missing the good old days. Ah, for Ord Mantell, where Separatists were bad and guns were good, and we could just run in shooting.
Has something changed? Are you, like, drunk?
I'm not noticing a drop-off in our rate of running in and shooting.
Yeah, we just have to do so much thinking first. Why don't we have more fun on this ship? Back home, when we needed a laugh, we used to run the Rontos in circles, then see if they could charge us without falling over.
Yeah, you gotta sleep it off.
Good night, Corso.
Maybe I should go lie down.
Alright. Well, that's all he has to say. Alright, we wanna go to the Republic fleet. And we gotta go talk to that, thing of, Satil Shan. Which is the Hammer Station one. Alright, and then now we don't even need to use Corso rigs anymore. It's gonna be fucking perfect. I can just have my dog, weird alien dog thing. But we'll have to summon the weird alien dog when we get onto the space station. Alright, well, Corso, your whole life is gonna be on the ship now. I wanna have my dog, the Takato, with me. Or, which I just wanna call it Dozer. That's its name. Come on, Dozer, let's go. Wait. Okay, I'm confused at why. In order to leave the area, I'd have to go around there when they both lead out, basically. Alright, yeah, let's go here. And now when we explore Terrace, we'll have Dozer with us the whole time. I don't think we get another companion until we complete Nar Shaddaa. And I think we get, like, a Wookiee companion on that one. There's, like, a Wookiee that uses, like, a freaking vibro sword. He's fucking great. And then doing this dungeon will be a little bit of extra XP, which is nice.
Hammer Station is destroyed, Master Satil.
Oh no, as I already did it.
Conquered worlds send their gratitude. The enemy has retreated to their home system.
Oh, well, I guess I'm not gonna do this because I already did it. So what's our, let's finish him off.
We shouldn't give the adversary hegemony a chance to regroup. Let's send the fleet to wipe him out.
There has been enough killing. The adversary learned a painful lesson today. One they won't forget.
You sound like a pussy, Satel Shan. Let's just murder them.
Survive destruction. Years ago, its autopilot was set to fly the station into a nearby star. According to the data you recovered, a mechanical failure cut...
Yeah, she actually does become your companion at some point, but it's only after Chapter 1's done. Alright. Yeah, this shouldn't have fucking happened, Satel Shan.
Didn't anyone from the Republic bother to make sure that the station was destroyed?
Failure occurred beyond our sensor readings. It took years for Hammer Station to drift where the Advosec salvagers could detect it. Regardless, your valiant efforts will be remembered. Take care. And may the Force be with you.
Alright, some credits. 22,000 XP. Neato, we're level 27 now. So, where do we want to go? We want to go to the main level. And then we just gotta go to the little smuggler, there we go, there's the smuggler hangar. And we'll just fly to Terrace, see the cutscene that plays, and then just kinda end it there, and then we'll do Terrace, at some point soon, I guess. Oh man, like, man, the Millennium Falcon, and like this, and the, they made that, I'm so glad they made the smuggler spaceship in this game look exactly like it, because it's like just the coolest ship to me in Star Wars. Because like, Han Solo is my favorite Star Wars character. So it's why I love the smuggler so much. I know when I originally played Star Wars The Old Republic, when the game first came out, I played a smuggler, so... In fact, I was also a Twi'lek smuggler. Just like this character is. Alrighty.
Master, at last. I am C2N2, steward of this vessel. It is my extreme good fortune to serve you.
Okay, well, get to work. I got stuff to do. I don't care what you have to say, little robot.
Prep the
Alright, let's head off to Terrace. Right, Terrace is over here. Should automatically. Oh no, it's not automatically playing a cutscene. We do have to speak to Risha though. And I guess, we just have to technically go on to the planet after that. Okay.
Ah, Terrace. Did you know you've just landed on the biggest graveyard in the galaxy? There's not much to enjoy here, besides skeletons, ruins, and man-eating creatures.
Good drinks? Are there good drinks there?
As long as there's a cantina, I'm happy.
Are all your inoculations up to date? I doubt the watering holes here rate more than a 1 in Trampetta's Star Guide. Taris was the Coruscant of the Outer Rim, until some lunatic leveled it centuries ago. Now it's a toxic swamp. We're here for an astrogation chart that was in a vault when Taris fell. That vault's somewhere in these ruins.
Alright. So, irrigation charts, huh?
What do we need with some musty old astrogation chart?
I worry about the why, and you take care of the how. That's our deal, remember? Our lost vault was designed to be recovered after a major catastrophe. All we need are the right sensors to locate it. The catch is, the only person I know with access to those sensors is someone who hates me.
Why is that?
I smell a good story. Let's just say she and I have a history, which I might tell you about when I know you better. I made our contact an irresistible offer. One of the deal's terms is that she doesn't have to see me. I need you to get that vault's location, Captain. Impress the stars out of her.
Alright, well, yeah, I can probably do that. Consider it done.
I'll do whatever it takes.
This woman talks tough, but underneath, she's a softy. Use that to your advantage.
Okay.
I should also warn you. Skavik knows about the vault. We can't let him catch up.
Alright, okay. Well, don't worry about it then. I'll make sure we hurry.
Relax. This is me we're talking about.
And I have every confidence in you. Well, almost every. The astrogation chart in that vault is essential to finding Nocturne's riches, Captain. Your contact name is Beryl Thorne. When Beryl gives you the vault's location, come back and see me. Oh, and try not to let anything eat you.
Alright. Well, I think I'm gonna end it there. I am going to, go and, relax for the rest of the day. Anyways, I'll see you all later. Have a wonderful day.